worthy, oh God. There's no one greater than you, oh God. Hallelujah. We worship you, Almighty King. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's Jehovah Nishkishini. Oh God, we thank you for being Jehovah Rapha. Oh, we thank you for being the King, oh God, the Lamb of Judah. We thank you, oh God, for being the one that have, God, the King's heart in your hand and turn the direction you desire for to go. Father, we worship you, oh God, for you are the one that, Lord God Almighty, that sent your word to heal us from all manner of sickness and disease. Father, you are the God that opened up the Red Sea, allow your people to go through on ground, oh God. You are the God that healeth, oh God, the minds of your people. Father, we come giving you praise, oh God. It's a time to give him glory. Oh God, we thank you for the battles already won, oh God. Father, we thank you, oh God, for being the I am God. Oh God, you are the first and the last, oh God. Oh God, you are the one, oh God, the almighty God. You are the Lion of Judah. You are the Prince of Peace. You are the Lamb of God. You are the King. Oh God, we thank you, oh God, for being Jehovah Tiskaniah. Father, you are everything we need, God. Father, everything we need is in you, oh God. Oh, Father, we come blessed in your name, God. Hallelujah, God. Father, we thank you, oh God, for being the one that knows our thoughts are far off, oh God. Father, you know the tent of our heart, God. Father, you know every thought, God, before we even think it, God. Oh, God, we thank you, oh God, for making our plane straight, God. Father, we thank you, oh God. Oh, God, for making a way out of no way, God. Oh, God, it's you, oh God, that open the doors of heaven, pour out a blessing that we won't have room to receive. Father, we give you all glory, God. We give you the praise, Father. Oh, God, it's you, oh God, who woke us up, start us on our way, God. Father, we didn't have our own mind, God. But, God, we woke up with your mind. We woke up with your heart. We woke up with praise to give you glory that is due to your name, God. We thank you for being a God that healeth thee. Oh, God, you're worthy, Father. We thank you and we bless your name. Hallelujah. Oh, God, I thank you right now. Hallelujah, God. Father, we thank you, oh, God. Father, it's you, oh, God, that set our destiny straight, God. You formed us in your image, God. Father, it was you, oh, God, who touched us, oh, God. You have the ability to put us on a potter's wheel and make us over, God. It's you, oh, Lord. Hallelujah. We just clay, God, but you're the potter. Father, we thank you, oh, God, for removing everything, God, that is not like you, oh, God. Father, we thank you, oh God, for being all-knowing, God. Father, the battle is already won in you. Father, we thank you right now, God, for our destiny is already set. And Father, we do have the victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come and give me praise. I say, come and give me praise. I say, come and give me praise, for he are worthy to be praised.
Oh God, you're worthy, oh God. You're worthy, oh God, you're worthy, oh God. You're worthy, oh God, you're worthy, oh God. Oh, Father God, we just come before your throne this morning, oh God, lifting up our hands unto you, oh God, lifting up our hearts unto you, oh God, with thanksgiving, oh Father God. We thank you, Father God, for these 21 days. We thank you, Father God, for what you took through us, took out of us, oh God, for what you placed in us, oh Father God. We thank you, Father God, for the path that you laid before us, oh Father God. We thank you, oh Father God. Oh Lord God, oh Kodoboshaya, we cannot praise you enough, oh Father God. Oh Father God, for you are the Alpha and the Omega. You know our ending from the beginning, oh Father God. You are the one, oh Father God, he that call the seas, oh Father God, and you tell them how far they can go, oh Father God. You are the one, oh Father God, that makes grass to grow on the mountains, oh Father God. You are the one, oh Father God, that stretches out the clouds, oh Father God, and they are a tent for you to dwell in, oh Father God. You are the one, oh Father God, oh Father God, that know, oh Father God, that know, oh Father God, our very thoughts before we think of, oh Father God. Oh Father God, for our very substance, oh Father God, you knew it, oh Father God, when we were in our mother's womb, oh Father God. Oh Father God, you are the all-knowing God. You are the all-wise God. Hey, Kodoboshah, you are the victorious glorious God. You are the only true God. So we lift you up this morning, oh Father God. We sing praises unto your name, oh Father God. For you are the one, oh Father God, that uphold us with your right hand of power, oh Father God. Oh Father God, we thank you for your word, oh Father God. For your word is forever established in heaven, oh Father God. For it is your word, oh Father God, that is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. For it is your word, oh Father God. Oh Father God, your word, oh Father God, that goes in us and is inscribed upon our hearts, oh Father God. For it is your word, oh Father God. Oh Lord God, that we live by, oh Father God. It is your word, oh Father God. Oh, that we live by, oh Father God. It is your word, oh Lord God, that directs us our paths, oh Father God. Oh Father God, so we thank you, oh Lord God. We thank you, oh Father God. So we say you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy.
Lift him up today, for he is God. He is God alone. He's worthy. Worthy. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. He's worthy. In Jesus' name. Yeah.
love you with the love of the Lord. Come on in, somebody greet your neighbor this morning. Hallelujah. Say welcome into the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome to Forever Praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, spread some love in this place. If you got some love in you, just give a little bit away. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're a loving church. Amen. 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 And we love you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come to give the Lord some thanks this morning. Amen.
Amen.
He's been real, real, real good. He's been better than good. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's been better than good. He's been real faithful.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tragedy.
to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hey. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. How many warriors we got in the house?
Hey.
Forever praise is a warrior nation. Warrior nation. Warrior nation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
His children unto victory. But the day has come for liberty. He came to set the captives free. We will live in victory. Calling all nations, calling all states. Warrior nation,
come on, come on.
Warrior people,
come on, come on.
Take your places,
come on, come on.
Release his kingdom,
come on, come on.
Powers of darkness and principalities. Oh yes, when two were destroyed, we will break the wickedness of the earth. The earth. Because the day has come for liberty, he came to set the captives free. We will live in victory. Calling all nations, cover your station. Warrior nation,
come on, come on.
Warrior people,
come on, come on.
Take your places,
come on, come on.
Release his kingdom,
come on, come on.
Tribe of Judah,
come on, come on.
Take up the warfare,
come on, come on.
Take your places,
come on, come on.
All of God's people,
come on, come on.
Say warrior nation,
come on, come on.
Warrior people,
come on, come on.
Take your places,
come on, come on.
Release his kingdom,
come on, come on. Come on, come on.
Warrior people,
come on, come on.
Take your places,
come on.
this is a united front in the realm of the spirit.
Fight, fight, fight,
we come to fight,
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 fight.
Let them rise, let them rise, let them rise.
Thank you. Power and the glory.
the kingdom. For thine is the kingdom. Of the gatekeepers. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Start the announcements.
cleaning for this week is on Monday for the dance team, Thursday praise and worship, Friday and Saturday dance and praise and worship. Hallelujah. Today after service, the youth will be taking orders for their 2017 Vacation Bible School t-shirts. Sizes up to 2X is $10 and larger will be $12. And the Vacation Bible School will be held on Monday, July the 24th through Friday, July the 28th. And Saturday, July the 29th, it will be the Friends and Family Day at the Sharon Woods Park from 12 to 5. This year's theme will be Hero Central, Discover Your Strength in God. T-shirts orders will be taken, placed after each service, and the deadline will be Friday, June 30th. If you have any questions, ask any of the youth pastors. And on tomorrow is City Gospel at 7. Also, if you have any questions, to speak with Pastor Tammy Jones. On this Wednesday at 7 will be the Watchman's Meeting. On this Wednesday at 7 p.m. will be the Watchman's Meeting. And on Wednesday, June the 21st, Let's Talk Youth Night for ages 10 and up is open to any adult who wishes to attend from 7 to 8:30 p.m. They will be discussing part 2 of suicide. If you have any questions, also to see the youth pastors. Outreach has extended the orders for their t-shirts until today, also to see Pastor Tammy for your t-shirt order. Also, Outreach is accepting both donations for food and clothing. And if you have any questions, also to see Elder Adrian and Andrea and Pastor Tammy. And the giveaway will be on Saturday, June 24th from 12 to 3 here at the church parking lot. Amen. Amen.
Also, this coming Saturday, we need people to go out. And, we're going out to minister and also hang door hangers on the doors for the outreach. Amen. So we need all the outreach people to be here at 12 o'clock on Saturday. Amen. The door hangers is on one side is going to have our function. What we're going to have on the 24th is going to It's like a flyer on the one side, and also on the flip side, it's going to have all the church information, everything they need to know about services, times, and everything. Amen. We just need to pass them all out. We need volunteers this coming Saturday at 12 o'clock.
Amen. Thank you for your offering. And at this time, we have a selection by Glorious Praise. After that, the next voice that you will hear will be that of our apostle, Pastor Tony Lashavo. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are my hiding place. You command, fill my heart with songs of deliverance whenever I'm afraid. I will trust in you. Thank you.
Father, your word says in Psalms 91 that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Father, it says that you've given your angels charge over us and that no plague would come nigh our dwelling. That means I don't have to be afraid because you're with me and you'll never leave me.
I will trust. And my
Lift your mind, lift your spirit.
Come on, lift them, lift your heart. Come on, just speak to the Lord in your spirit. There's another place of worship. There's another place of yielding. There is another place of communing with God. The music can't take you. But it's more than just your part, your thing, your position, your part you play in making the whole service, if you will, come together. So it's deeper. If you don't know Him in a deep way, it will only be an experience. Body comes together and we worship and we Shabbat God and we pray the prayers that need to be prayed, but there has to be an inward connection. It has to connect inward in the inward man where your confessions lie, where your true thoughts of God and people and everything that God has called you to do, if it's not real to you down deep. Most of us don't feel it out here because we don't feel it in. When you feel it down deep, and He's God, the all-powerful one, the all-knowing one, when the ever-present one becomes real to you down deep, You lift your legs, you lift your hands. You'll understand why some people just float. Because He's real to you deeply. Deep. Deep. Out of everything we were called to do, everything we were called to be, there must be, even if you have people that call on you and look for your wisdom, it's even beyond wisdom. It's beyond the gift, it's intimacy. And everything that we're called to be, everything that we're called to do, we need that intimate element that makes everything that we're called to be and makes everything that you're called to do. And when it's down deep, you don't have do God, because how can we have do God when He's real to you deeply? You can't. It's impossible for God Almighty, the creator of everything, to be in you in a real way and you have to Him. It's impossible. That's why the struggle is, because it's not down deep. It's not inward. The struggle is inward. Down deep. Because it's what's inward, down deep, down. Hallelujah. When the spirit moves and where your thoughts are and the seat of the emotions and your feelings, your real beliefs. It don't matter what you confess. It goes beyond your confession. But what you believe down deep is everything. And the foundation must be laid in your soul. The soul is the one that cries out.
The soul is the part of you that remembers everything. It quotes scriptures and it has everything. Everything that's ever happened to you is lodged in your soul. So the reason why some of you have position, you have the gifts, you have following, but you have no conviction. Conviction is a lifestyle. Is beyond what I see with my natural eye. Is what I see in the spirit. What I see in your soul is what makes you you and me me. So it's a bad thing that God has to fight and do all kind of supernatural things just to convince us. He has to go in the supernatural, create situations, come through problems to convince us that's called by his name to believe that he's real. That's all. Because when you believe that he is, when you believe in the I am, when you serve the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end of time, of all things, the one that has all things in his hand, when you serve him with your whole heart, it's impossible, impossible to have to him. Against the spirit of Jehu. Jehu is a half-hearted person. At best, you can only get half or a little bit to God. God don't want that. He wants all or none. Do you know God is an all of you or none of you? God, why? Because he created you. You didn't create him. He created you. He blew his breath into your body, gave you life. You can't tell him what to do. You can't dictate to him. He dictates to you. But because we've gotten these in these big places, maybe it's your money, maybe with your title, maybe with people, something caused your head to swell. Your head has to swell if you think you can do things your way. And you come in here and you shout, shut up, God, you real, God, you real. Then a situation come and you start slacking back. What happened to that forward praise? What happened to that push on the altar? What happened when God gave you everything you wanted him to give you? He confirmed, he moved through situation. What happened? See, God's getting that wayward. That's what a wayward Christian, that wayward mindset out the way. Because we're no good half best. Especially not in this time. Because it's the half of you that will get you in trouble. I'm going to say this over here. A lot of us don't realize, Pastor Sean, that it's the half of you that's not submitting to God that gets you in trouble. But it's the half part of you that you want to sweep under the rug. Don't want nobody to mess with you. How many of you know God is messing with you? It's not the devil. You can't blame this one on the devil because it's too much invested in you. So he has to shake your world. He has to shake our world. There's too much. It don't matter how much you want to do it and what you deserve. Guess what? We don't deserve nothing outside of what God called us to have. I'm going to say that again. You don't deserve anything past what God ordained for you to have. You don't deserve it. If you got 1,000 but you desire 5,000, it don't matter. God said 1,000.
but you may desire it. That's what gets us in trouble. We want more than what God wants to give us. But in this season, the Lord said, I'm showing you what I want you to have, and that's all I'm going to give you. You know how doors used to fling open? So some of us will get in trouble, more trouble, if God give us more than what you need. So I'm going to say this to some of you. Some of you, God is not going to move. Oh, this is the part. I don't prophesy houses. I'm going to tell you, this season, God is not going to move. This season, God's not going to give you everything you want. But he's going to supply you with what you need in this hard place. Why? That's the only way some of us will be made. I don't know about you, that's how I was made. Tough. Dry. See, when you used to getting dry and being tough and being hard and ugly, but that's the only way that your hard head self will obey. That was me. Let things get hard. Get hard. That's why now I'm at my best in a hard place. Hallelujah. Not because it's hard on my flesh. It's because I understand. When you understand something that you've gone through, Trina, God is going to give you an understanding because you need it. You need an understanding not because you deserve it, but you need it because this is the season that you got to shift. Shift. This is the hour within the season. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Season, hour, and then a moment come when God looks at you. The Lord said to me, he said, tell her that I'm listening. Tell her I'm listening to her confessions. Tell her I'm listening to what she says because it's about to get hard. And you gotta be in the place before this place takes place. You gotta be in this place because things are gonna happen around you and you're gonna need the life of the Spirit. Life in your belly. Life in your mind. Life in your confessions. God is about to shake your world. But this shaking is coming to align you, woman of God, called of God, sitting on God. This season is the season to shake all of the hell out of you. I'm talking about the hell, the devil. All of the agreements that the devil has been working against you, this season is going to break you, cut you. That's the only way you're going to submit. God said, immediately he will anoint you if you agree with him. If you agree, you'll be anointed in this trial and you'll come out smokeless. Not a stitch of smoke. Not a singe of your hair. And everybody that will connect to you, God will change everything as if you never got out of place. But the vital, your instructions are agree with God. Do what you know to do. Because I see the wind as your pastor coming. But this will be one of the greatest shifting for you. Hear me, body, watcher, go through. Because guess what? I saw the end. Come on and give God a hand clap. Oh! I saw the end. I saw the end. Come on, lift your hand. He korabosa. Sandalaba. I see the end from the beginning, says the Lord. I'm putting a fight in you, says the Lord. Oh, shall I? It's coming out of you, says the Lord. Stand on your feet. I hear the Lord say, fight. He come on, shut up. Oh, shut up. I hear the Lord say, fight. Come on, oh, shut up. I hear the Lord say, fight. I hear the Lord say, fight. Come on, shut up. I see a fight coming out of you. Come on, lift those hands. All of it come to provoke the God in you. It's already there. But your situations and circumstances are upon you so that you can stand. God told me to tell you that He's putting a stand, unmovable, a steadfast stand in you, because the devil's been pushing you around. But God said, not so. She called it like, and I hear the Lord say that I am charging you, O woman of God, to stay the course. And I'm charging you, O woman of God, to pray the prayer. There's a prayer in your belly. And the Lord thy God is provoking you because of the investment. He's invested much in you. But I also hear the Lord say unto you that as you hear and move in the spirit and obey God, every situation that comes, God is going to turn it. All of them. Every situation that will come, I heard the Lord say, I'm going to shift it and I'm going to turn it for you. Oh, I see him coming. Oh, Shebaka. I see the situations. Hey, Korobo Shata. But I see all of them, all of them, all of them. God is going to confound the enemy. Just for you. All you got to do is put a praise on it. He called a shot. Hey. He called a shot. All you got to do is put a praise on it. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, put a praise on it. Come on, put a praise on it. He called a shot. All you got to do is put a praise. And this is a praise that only God can anoint. Has nothing to do with your style and how nice you can flow. But when God puts a praise, a step in your pep, a pep in your step, hallelujah, heaven, Hoshima, will respond to your praise. Come on, lift them. Come on. Come on, come on.
powerful. God is moving on. I do have a word. The Lord said to me, he said, I'm anointing the forerunners. He called up the ones that are called out of their family to run forth and to pave the way.
Hear me. This press, this 21 days, was for many reasons, but one of the main purposes is that the ones that were called in this hour, the Lord said, I'm going to anoint them with an unquenchable fire, and they're going to run forward. He called them outside. That's why the witches, the warlocks, the devil has come to try to stop this move, but the devil has no power. I'm talking about Messiah against God. It was meant for us to stand. He called them outside. It was meant to stand. This attack came from peculiar. But ones that were called to stand at the gate, he called them. Hear me. When God calls you to stand in the spiritual gate, in the spreading position, you got to be made out of something. You have to have some spiritual stamina. He called them. And you got to know how, when you got to bear. Come on, sir. He called them a sire. You got to know how to press when it hurts. He called out of a sire. You got to know how to press when your mind is under attack. He called out of a sire. Because this press comes from an anointing that the devil can't consume. That's why key people were under attack. Because you have to know it. By the Spirit. Hold up a sire. By the Spirit. He called up a sire. I want these people, I want you to come. I got the word, but I want these people to come to this altar. I want Keisha, Kim, Bill, Andrew, Yolanda, Hesha, Tyrone. You represent one generation, Helena. You represent another one, Korabasa. Hey, Mariah, he called up. Yes. Oh, I feel this one. Angie, Louise, hey, the Banks, Tony, Kaya, Ellie Gale. Felicia, Shalana, Andrew Garnett, Lorraine, Ebony. I'm standing in a gap for you, Renee. You just stay on those congas. You Paige, you Roosevelt, you Sean. Come on, put those feet up. Come on. Look at this. Forerunner, look at this.
Yeah.
He could. He called a Messiah. Your prophetic anointing and your gift about to open up. He called, you shall prophesy. He called a Messiah. You will lay hands on your family. You will prophesy, and they will know that a prophet has been amongst them. And I hear the Lord say, I'm separating for a season, but not isolating. Because they're going to begin to understand what God has invested in you. Hey. Call. Hosha. And I hear the Lord say, favor. Because he said he's going to elevate you in the midst of your foes. Because he said you will not take the glory from him for what he's about to do. And all you gotta do is give him more praise. Huh? Hush up. That's all you gotta do is give him more praise. That's it, come on, lift him up. Come on, lift him. Hush. Because when you feel this one gonna break you through. This one gonna break you through. Come on, come on, come on. This one. That's it. Come on, lift them. Come on, Andrew, take his arm. And the Lord said, I anoint you this day. Lift your hand. I feel the fire. I receive it. I receive it. Your hearing will change. Your vision will change. Your thrust will change. The Lord said, this endowment that I'm giving you, you've never had it before. He said, now receive it. Come on, say, Lord, I receive. I feel fire in this place. Say, Lord, I receive it. Come on, raise those hands. Tell the Lord, say, Lord, I receive. No more time wasted. Come on, say, I receive it, Derek. Derek Carter. Head shot. Head shot. I see the wind blowing. Another boldness coming. I saw your eyes open. And I saw God anoint you with power. Especially that healing power. That healing anointing. Oh, I see it. Push up. And Robin, this one gonna break you through. What you waiting to happen, just happen just like that. You say God with it. God knows. God said I'm doing it just like that. 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 Almost. Just like that. Just like that. Come on. Just like that. That's it. Put them up. Because this weight is a spirit of tiredness that I see that can attack you. It is a heavy that come and weigh you down. But the Lord says supernatural virtue and supernatural strength, because that thing breaks just like that. Almost time. Just like that. Hold shabaka. That was an attack of fatigue. But guess what? Your strength coming in your legs. Oh. Hey, your strength coming in those legs, because you're a warrior. You're the one that's supposed to move them. Come on. Move them. Cut them. That's it. You got anointing in your place. And the enemy will always try to fight it. You want him to move, pick those legs up. Hey, that's it. Just like that. Just like that. Hallelujah. You can go. Just like that, Janae. Come on, get up. You got a reason to praise. Oh, come on, lift those legs. Your virtue, your stamina is going to supersede the stamina that you have. Hey, what God's giving you is supernatural. He comes. That's it. Pick them up. you got a reason to praise God. And I say to you, Nadia, welcome into your new season. Welcome into your new place. He caught up a seat. I felt fire just fall down on your head. Felicia, touch her mind. I felt it. Fire. Touch her. Touch her. Her mind. It's coming off just like that. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let all things be established. In the spirit. In our hearts and our mind. Father, thank you that we see as you will have us to see. Hear, feel. From obedience to the 21 days of prayer, this made it the last day. I want Sherry to come here. Come here. Tell Sherry to come. I need this oil. Some oil in your pretty hair. Hallelujah. Because God said so. Come on, lift your hands. The very thing you fought, the very thing you played down, is what you are. The Lord said, he said, before the foundations of this earth I formed you, I've ordained you to be a prophet. In your mother's womb, I called you and I set you apart for such
a time as this. And I know that you are not under. I'm just speaking what the Lord said to speak over you, confirming with witnesses of who you are. To God, I've ordained you a prophetess. And the Lord spoke to me. He said, today, your life changed. You've weathered. He said, you've done everything he told you to do. Not according to your ability, but according to his. And the Lord said, this day I anoint you. I position you as a prophetess of God. I know you want to be Sherry. You can be Sherry, but you're a prophetess of God, fashioned for such a time as this. And now I anoint thee. I've waited for this time. Now I just anoint you with oil. Doesn't mean nothing more than what's already been taking place. And Lord, anoint you today, and the dealings of the Lord will never be the same. The oil will never run dry. The thrust of prayer. Let's see. Sister Jackie Hopkins, I need some more oil in that. If I ever seen a warrior in the making, if I ever been a witness to what God is doing and has done, so have I seen it with you. Come. Sister Jackie, the Lord told me to tell you, I want you to stand a little closer. He said, well done. Well done. Come on and clap your hands. You're talking about been through the fire. Stripping after stripping. I witnessed it. And seeing and watch you press. And hold on to nothing but the word. Everything around you crumbled. God allowed it to crumble just to elevate you this day. Now your making as a prophet has begun. Your making and your position as an intercessor. Come here, Angie and Joe and Mama. What you said you will never do, you have submitted. Do. Prayer warrior. Prophetess anointing. You will never be the same. In your struggle, in your mind. Rika! Come on, lift those hands. Come on, lift them, lift them. Come on, lift them. Lift them. It's a holy place. It's a holy place. It's a holy, holy. Holy. Prophet Tyrone. The Lord told me to tell you complete restoration. Financially, spiritually, emotionally restored, prophet of God, immediately. Immediate. It's over.
it's over. Just like that. Now you about to benefit as if nothing ever happened. Shut up! Nothing. You weathered it. Now the benefits of saying yes the way you said yes to God. It's happened just like that. Just like that. Only God can restore now the word. The dam has broken. The waters have been released. Now, God honor your mother for you in a way that you never know. It's a prayer that only a mama can pray for their seed. Your mother's position saved your life. Lord, I bless you. Chandela Bukusa. Come here, sister Nina, who I feel the power of God. I am honored to anoint you today. Honored, hear me. I am honored and grateful to anoint you. Grateful to God. Honor. The Lord spoke to me. He said, anoint her now because I've elevated her and you've caught the mantle that's on your life. You little, but you're powerful. You have an awesome prophetic anointing and you have awesome prayer. The Lord told me, he said, if you need someone to stand up against the enemy, place her in the midst. He said, place her in the midst of the enemy. For you are anointed to pray and reverse the powers of darkness. Warrior. And prophetess, you know you are. Your life in the spirit has changed. Sunnybrook, you will never be the same from this day forward. You will never be the same. Power to endure and to stand, fight and war, stamina. God has given you. And he said, as you we go forth, always place her in the midst of them. Shut up! Shut it! Your very life repels darkness. And God is proud of your commitment to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, lift those hands. Bless her. Hallelujah. Come on and clap your hands. Hallelujah. Come on and clap your hands. Come on, open your big mouth. This ends our 21 days of prayer. I have this word Sunday. Amen. Man, I don't want to put a